welcomes the quarterbacks of the NFL in Family Feud's preview of the 1994 Super Bowl. For the American Football Conference, from the New York Jets, Boomer Esiason. From the Buffalo Bills, Jim Kelly. From the Houston Oilers, Warren Moon. From the Seattle Seahawks, Stan Gilmore. From the Los Angeles Raiders, Vince Evans. Playing for the National Football Conference, from the San Francisco 49ers, Steve Young. From the Phoenix Cardinals, Steve Berline. From the Chicago Bears, Jim Harbaugh. From the New Orleans Saints, Wade Wilson. From the Detroit Lions, Andre Ware. And the mascot of the National Football League, Ray Cohn.
I threw my arm out. Thank you very much. Thank you so very much. And welcome to this Family Feud where I am announcing that I'm going to play for the NFL. Thanks for laughing. We have two of the greatest teams in NFL history. 10 great quarterbacks, 5 from the AFC against 5 from the NFC. They want to have the chance to play for maybe upwards of $20,000 for one great charity. Who will get the chance to play for cystic fibrosis? Right now, we're going to call for our wonderful bullseye game to see what that bank is going to be. Boomer! Here we go. Steve Young. That feels so good.
Good to see you, Ray.
Nice to see you guys, too.
You sure you want to play?
Well, I'm the guy that puts $5,000 automatically in both banks, and if my hand is messed up.
100?
What number are you? 100?
Watch that. Oh, there went $5,000. Now you can make it 20. This is worth $1,000 if you know the number one answer. We ask 100 people, name a fictional character with the initials D.D. Steve.
Donald Duck.
Yes. Good answer.
Is it Donald Duck for the bullseye?
Yes.
Bullseye! And $6,000 going to the bank of the NFC. Steve Berline, Jim Kelly. $2,000, the value of this question. Again, it was asked of 100 men. Give me number one. What would bother you more if a teenager called you dude, sir, or pops? Jim?
Pops.
Did our 100 men say pops?
Yes.
Bullseye! Jim adds $7,000 to the AFC Bank, and we continue. Come on, Jim. Chicago against Houston. Warren, the number one answer adds $3,000. We ask 100 people, name something that most men do too much of. Jim?
Drinking.
Is drinking number one on our survey? Hit the bullseye, Warren. Something that most men do too much of.
Eating.
Eating. Is that worth $3,000? What was the bullseye? Boomer said watch TV. We missed it. Let's go with another bank building question. You can make up for the $3,000 you lost with this $4,000 question. 100 people answered this. What can cause you to perspire? Stan?
Exercise.
Do you add $4,000 with exercise? Bullseye! $11,000 going to the AFC quarterbacks bank. Here comes Andre of the Detroit Lions. The Raiders are ready. $5,000 for a single answer, but 100 men answered only. Name something difficult to do without a mirror. Andre?
Comb your hair.
Are you going to add $5,000 with comb your hair? Listen to me now. We ask 100 men, name something difficult to do without a mirror.
Shave.
Is shave turning 11,000 into 16? Bullseye! Shave! $15,000 going into the bank for the quarterbacks of the AFC. NFC, $6,000. And we're going to come right back to play the view. We are back with this very special feud. Before we play, take a moment to introduce our great teams. We've got the AFC quarterbacks headed by Boomer Esiason of the New York Jets.
You got... Hey, how you doing, okay?
I'm doing okay. You're doing better. You have a bank of $16,000 built by your teammates. And it's a great charity. You're going to tell us just a little bit about...
The reason we're doing it for cystic fibrosis, unfortunately for my family, we found out about my son having cystic fibrosis on May 6th of this year. So it's very dear to my heart, but not only for him, but for all cystic fibrosis patients. I've asked my friends around the league, the NFL, Family Feud, and everybody to pitch in, and sure enough, here we are, and I'd like to say thank you to everybody.
Fortunately for cystic fibrosis, they're going to have a good friend in you. Tell all the great players you brought to help you give this money.
Well, this is Jim Kelly of the three-time AFC champion Buffalo Bills.
That's right.
Warren Moon, one of the most prolific passers in all of the NFL. Stan Galbaugh not only plays for the Seattle Seahawks, but was the World League MVP. And our ace in a hole down there is Vince Evans from the Los Angeles Raiders.
It's nice to meet the A-team. Will you play for your $16,000, or will the NFC, headed by Steve Young, play for the bank they built? 49ers, they're glad to have you, I know.
I hope so.
Tell everybody who you brought with you, because you'd like the bragging rights to play for this charity.
Yeah, we really would. In fact, thanks for Boomer for inviting us. On my team, Steve Berline with the Phoenix Cardinals. Next to him, Jim Harbaugh from the great Chicago Bears. Wade Wilson, New Orleans Saints, our arch rivals. And down at the end, Andre Ware from the Detroit Lions.
Nice to have your great team here. You've built this $6,000 bank. We held applause so that we could get into the feud. Let's go! We don't want to waste time. The first team to 300 points wins the game and will play fast money for their bank. Steve Young has once beaten Boomer Esiason in a face-off. We'll see how they do now. First question was asked of 100 people. Listen carefully. Top six answers are on that board. Give me the most popular. Name something people practice doing in a sexy way. Steve?
Getting dressed.
All right, let me. I'm see if it's up there. Show me how you get dressed in a sexy way, Steve. Real fast. Show me real fast.
I was thinking a woman.
Show me how a woman gets dressed in a sexy way. You're a Mormon, Steve. Tell me about it. Let me see. Get dressed. Didn't make the survey. Something people practice doing in a sexy way. Say it, Boomer. 100 people.
Getting undressed.
Getting undressed.
Well, see, that's the
Mormon answer, Gentile answer. Let me see getting undressed. Yeah. It's there, you think of the steel. Boomer, show them your little technique that you use when you take it. Stop it. Believe me, Jim Kelly, we know you practiced it. My good buddy, people practice doing in a sexy way. What would 100 people say?
Dancing.
Show me. Dancing, 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 bam! Automatic, systematic, one. Practice doing in a sexy way. 3 seconds.
I can't think of
anything. Well, that's one strike. Pick it up, Stan.
How about walking?
You got a sexy walk?
Not really.
You practice it?
No, I wouldn't tell you if I did.
Thank you for being so enthusiastic about this. Show me the sexy walk. Number one! Vince, a lot of these women were screaming, you are sex. Now, what do you practice doing in a sexy way? What would 100 people say?
Let's see, eye contact.
Let me see. Eye contact. Yeah! Come on, Boomer. Bank is growing. People practice doing in a sexy way. Take a guess. You got 3 seconds.
How about eating?
Eating. Thank you for buzzing before I had a chance to say something I regretted. 2 strikes. People practice doing in a sexy way.
2 of them. Smiling or...
No, smiling, no. He says.
Hold on.
You said one answer. Let me see smiling. You only said one answer. Can you steal it? People practice doing in a sexy way. Andre, anything? Anything?
Kissing.
Kissing? They said eating. Steve, they said talking. One answer. They said talking and they said kissing. You may go. I call for calm. You can steal this bank.
Okay, we have a consensus here. Talking.
people practice talking?
On the phone, you know. Hey, baby. Sexy voice. Sexy
Show
voice.
Me a, very quickly a sexy I gotta go.
This is a Jim Kelly. Hey, baby, what's happening?
What'd you say?
He said when you call him, you say, hey, baby, what's up?
What's up?
Let's see,
I'll show you what's
for
up.
The steal and the first bragging rights, talking sexy. They did it! This fight goes right here. Jim, you had another answer. Were you trying to say number four? Set over here. Huh? Believe me, I've met some people that should. We're going to come right back, and this feud is going to continue. Two great teams and one great charity after this. You just tuned in. We got 10 great NFL players playing for cystic fibrosis. We're doubling the point value. Top six answers are on the board. We ask 100 people, now listen carefully, specifically, name something you think has turned some fans against pro sports today. Jim?
Gambling.
Is Steve had to look and see that he lost. It's amazing. Is gambling going to give you control? Not on our survey. Listen to the wording. 100 people answered. Something you think has turned some fans against pro sports.
The cash. The money. Salaries.
Salaries. Let me. Hey. Let me see. The big money you got for going to Phoenix.
As mad as they want.
All right, let me see salaries. It's number one. High salaries. Said by 39 people. Yeah, if you want to complain about salaries, I think he got 40 million. I don't. What has turned some fans against pro sports today?
How about drug or alcohol abuse?
Let me see. Chemical abuse. Big steroid users, yeah. That's right. Wade?
What about free agency, unloyalty to your former team?
I like that.
Could you get more specific? It sounded like a legal case there. Free agency meaning the lack of loyalty to a team.
Right.
Let me see whatever Wade said. Strike one, little hope for the AFC. Andre, are you having as much fun as you've seen?
Yes.
Okay.
Thinking. I'm thinking.
What would our 100 people say has turned some fans against pro sports?
Bad decisions by management, like different trades.
Could you name a few management people you personally don't like?
No, I'm going to stay quiet.
Okay, bad
know.
Decisions by management. That's two strikes. You think of a steal. You have the largest bank. I don't think a lot of fans are thinking about, I hate the management. Steve.
I'd say, you know, too much hype on the field, celebrations, you know.
Okay.
Kind of
is your team still alive with too much hoopla on the field except for the game? Three strikes. You get in the game. One answer to help him, Vince. What do you think has turned some fans against pro sports?
Media.
The media?
I would say the length of the game. They last forever.
Well, there's four quarters, you see, and you have to play. Okay.
High ticket prices.
High ticket prices, length of the game.
Ticket prices.
Media. You tell him what you really think, but he's, I know Boomer, he's independent. He's going on his own. What will you say?
Ticket prices.
Do you steal the big bank with ticket prices? You're in the game. 138 points of double value comes this way. Steve, nobody said number four. Some fans don't like commercialization. Some don't like, how many, these guys have 50 sponsors themselves. Number five. Players, bad attitudes. And number six. Season is too long. Here we go with what could be our final face-off. The point value's tripled. Either team can win this game if you take this question all the way out. 100 people answered. Six answers are there. Listen carefully. Tell me something the school bully always took away from you. Jim?
How about your lunch money?
Is lunch money there? You can win with a steal. Here we go. Something the school bully always took away from you.
Your girlfriend.
Your girlfriend. Not there. Andre, quickly.
About your pencils.
Pencils. 180, Steve.
Your lunchbox.
Your lunch pail. Steve?
Your homework.
Homework. Two strikes, think of a steal. That's why I always did mine wrong, so when he stole it, he got an F.
Your clothes, it's a hat or something.
Are you still alive with your clothes? This game is going to be over, gentlemen, if Boomer can steal. Tell me something the school bully always took away from you. What's up there, Vince? Three answers. Anything, Stan?
How about your seat?
Took your seat away from you.
Your bike?
Your bike? Bike? Nothing. Thank you, Jim. Now, Boomer, what would 100 average people say the bully always took away from them to win the game?
I'm going to have to say that he took away... God, I was the bully, and I can't remember.
Give me an answer.
No, he took away your place in line.
If your place in line is there, you've won, and if not, it goes to the NFC place in line. No, the NFC wins! We heard some other answers. You would have won if you said number three. Bullies took away candy.
Candy.
Bullies take away number four. Bicycle. Warren, you should have made him say it. And bullies take away number five. Books. Nobody said. You guys stay right here. And I need two players for Fast Money. We're coming right back. As you first, bye-bye. As the NFC goes for Cystic Fibrosis, $6,000. Stay tuned. We're back. The NFC going for $6,000 with 15 seconds on that clock for Cystic Fibrosis. Good luck. We ask 100 people, how old were you when you first played Spin the Bottle?
13.
Name an occupation that gets no respect.
Comedian.
The sport with the handsomest men.
Football.
Who was the last person to scold you?
My mother.
On an airplane, name something that's too small.
Seat.
Turn around. That's five at the buzzer. How old were you in your first place? Spin the Bottle? You said you were spinning it at 13. Survey said 15 on the board. What occupation gets no respect? You said comedian. Survey said zero. The handsomest men you thought were in? Football. That's why they cover their faces. The survey said 23 agree. The last person to scold you, you chose your mother. What did the survey say? Big one. 36 on an airplane, you said. The seats were too small, survey said. Bam, 25. Excellent job. Back with your teammates. 101 away. Steve Berline bringing home for $6,000. You look straight ahead as I place 20 seconds on the clock. Reveal your partner's answers. Let's see you do it. We ask 100 people, how old were you when you first played Spin the Bottle?
13.
Try again.
14.
Name an occupation that gets no respect.
Teacher.
The sport with the handsomest men.
Football.
Try again.
Baseball.
Who was the last person to scold you?
My dad.
On an airplane, name something that's too small.
Seats. Leg room.
Try again.
He said leg room.
Is that the same as seats? Okay. What do you do, Jeff? Okay. Seats have been given. Another answer.
Overhead.
It is separate. Turn around. You need 101. How old were you when you first played Spin the Bottle? You said? 14. Survey said 5. 12 would have been number one. Occupation that gets no respect, you chose a great one of teachers. Survey chose 11. Trash collector would have been number one. The handsomest men, you chose the sport of baseball. Survey set. Bam, 26.
Ray, we didn't hear his answer to this next question.
Okay. All right. Trash collector gets no respect. Baseball is the best looking. The question was, the last person to scold you, he said teacher one more time.
He said dad.
He said dad. Allow me to be authoritative. Settle down. I'm in control. Hey,
that's right.
You said mother. You said father. All parents were included, so you got a second chance, and you said teacher. Right. That's why they get no respect, because they scold you. All right. What did the survey say? Zero. All parents were inclusive. It would have been number one. Comes down to this now. On an airplane, something that's too small, you said leg room. You need a big one. What did the survey say? 11. Bathroom was the number one answer not given. $5 a point. Come and hug him. Give him a handshake. 760, a valiant effort. We're coming right back. The Cystic Fibrosis in the NFL. Stay tuned.
A member of our studio audience will receive for the man who's good at making a woman feel great, Pierre Cardin, man's cologne. Back to Ray.
For the NFL, the Family Feud, and Cystic Fibrosis, thanks for watching. See you next time.
This is Gene Woods speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson television production.